Before I announce the team and go into that stuff, I just want to tell you guys that I'm very happy with the season that we had. Obviously, coming into the season and losing so many girls, and I told the girls in the very beginning I wasn't sure what we were going to get. I knew we had some girls that could play softball. I didn't know how we would gel as a team. I wasn't sure what we were going to get for probably the first time since I've been here. I've been pretty consistent with being accurate as far as the team and what we were going to do. This is the first year where I wasn't sure. After our first tournament, I knew what we were capable of. I can honestly stand up here and tell you guys, like I've told you before, I don't know if I've had a better gel team that has played together and played for each other as much as you guys have. Obviously, the girls that we brought up and the girls that have been here coming together and becoming one, I mean, that's pretty much the reason for your success. Having been here when I came in, I mean, it was a losing program. We've been a winning program, but you guys did things that no other team has done here. We've had some pretty good players here. But to go 8-1, to start 8-0 is something that the school's never done before. To make it the second round of CIF is something that the school's never done before. To have the game that we had to get knocked out, you know, and then have the team that we lost to go on to win the CIF championship, I think stings even a little bit more to me because I know that we were better than them that day. And we had a chance to, you know, bring Great Oak their first CIF championship here. So it's definitely something to build on. But like I said, going into the season and sitting here now and reflecting back on the season it was a special year. There's no doubt about it. It started with you guys. It started with the parents. It started with, you know, having the fans that we had here this year that we've never had in the past. So I think it's going in the right direction. I think that you guys have definitely carried on the tradition and continued to build it even more. And, you know, it's going to be something to uphold next year. So I look forward to next year. With that being said, we're going to go ahead and I'm going to introduce our Great Oak softball team. And you guys can come up and get your letters, and I want you to stay up here if you would. Come on, Corinne Van Schaik. Kayla Green. Madison Neff. Lupe Nejo. Sydney Preston. Dylan Stansel. Emily Burrow. Natalie Bishop. Samara Arriaga. Autumn Storms. Stephanie Cervantes. So Elizabeth Engler, Savannah Hewitt, not here either, huh? Serena Quinata, and Victoria Paquel, who can join us tonight. Again, these are the girls who made history at Great Oak, right here, Great Oak softball. Great season, you guys. Okay. Now to the personal awards. What we do is we have a spirit award every year, and I have the girls vote on it. And then whatever they come with, typically I'll look over it, and then we're good, we go. And then I also have the league awards for first and second team.
So starting with the spirit award.
Spirit award, who significantly contributed to the goals of the team in concert with consistent stellar scholastic performance. And that went to Corinne Van Schaik. Desire Award. Through your significant contributions to the team's goals demonstrated a love for the sport, outstanding work ethic, hustle, determination, and persistence. And that was voted to Laura Curry. Involvement Award, who significantly contributed to the team's goals while consistently contributing to the school and community above and beyond athletics. And that was voted for Dana Whalen. Award, who significantly contributed to the team's goals while demonstrating a higher of understanding for the sport. And that was voted to Stephanie Cervantes. Is the Integrity Award, who significantly contributed to the team's goals while demonstrating outstanding leadership qualities and respectful approach to coach, teammates, opponents, and fans. Dylan Stansel. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Tori Bacall. For Teamwork Award, who best exemplifies cooperation with teammates to accomplish the common goals of the team. And that was voted to Emily Burrow. Again, that last award I could probably give to every girl on this team because, like I said before, they all played for the right reasons. They all played for each other, and there was nobody bigger than anybody else on this team. So I think that that had a lot to do with what these girls did and what they represented for the program this year. It had a lot to do with our success. So great job. And there's your Spirit Award winners. Give my hand. Second team all league. What this is it's voted on by all the coaches, and what we do is we put names up there of who we think should be there, and then we take a vote that goes into a hat, and then it comes out blind, and obviously the top kids get the spots. I believe that the first team is only 10 kids, and then the second team I believe is 10 also. So from our school, our second team went to Sydney Preston. Serena Quinata. Emily Burrow. And I wasn't good with this, but it went to Laura Curry also. Snub job there. Not that I don't disagree with our first team, I just think we had one more than this. So, our first team went to Dylan Stansel. Autumn Storms. This is Great Oaks All-League team. We have a coach's choice, we have an offensive MVP, we have a defensive MVP, we have an MVP, and we have an award that I created a couple years ago called the Iron Wolf Award. Obviously the coach's choice is something that we put out for somebody that we kind of put through the ringer a little bit, maybe isn't quite used to what we're doing, but take it all on, handle it, find a way to get it done, and be that productive player that we need. And it's not always easy. Sometimes it's out of position, a little bit uncharacteristic of what they're used to, but somehow, someone they find a way to get it done. So this year that award went to Emily Burrow. Next is the Iron Wolf. That is a saying that I tell the girls a lot, is I think that I'm not the easiest guy to play for all the time, but I'm a firm believer that iron sharpens iron, and you know, it's not always good. We butt heads sometimes, but it's all for the same goal. And you know, I absolutely push the girls more than most coaches, I understand that, but I think, you know, with what we do here, you know, I think they respond to it. It takes a certain type of kid, and that's to play for me. I've always said that, but these girls find a way to get it done. This is somebody that has definitely taken a lot from Ryan and I, but finds a way to get it done and be highly productive, and she is truly a piece of iron to us. This award goes to Kayla Green. Next, our offensive MVP. There's probably multiple girls on the team that could have had this. Obviously somebody that drives in a lot of runs for us, anchors our offense, pretty consistent throughout the year, and somebody we like to be up in that situation. She's been very consistent for us all year. So this award went to Dylan Stansel. Next is our defensive MVP. Little tougher this year because I think in the past we've had one rock that's kind of nailed it down. This year we've obviously needed two and sometimes three. Bringing a freshman up was something that we weren't sure where it was going to fit at first. But obviously she did a great job, and our returning, you know, chucker in the circle is solid as always. So this year was a little back and forth for us. I don't think that we were as consistent as we're used to or like to be, and at points where we weren't, these two found a way to get it together. So we co-MVP'd this year with both of our pitchers, with Sydney Preston and Autumn Storms. Great Oaks MVP obviously speaks for itself. It's a player that does everything the right way, from offense to defense to leadership to just impacting the game. Somebody that we're going to have a tough time not having next year. So how you are the MVP of a team that's 8-1 and you're making second league all team, I have no idea. But it is what it is, and this goes to Laura Curry. Congratulations, you guys. Thanks for a great season. Appreciate it. Okay. Obviously, this is the toughest part every year for me. But we lose girls every year. Obviously, every girl on our team is very important to what we do, or they wouldn't be here. They were all hand-selected. This particular player is a senior that's her first year at Varsity, that's been in our program for all 4 years. Came onto the team, worked her butt off every day, first to practice, did what she was asked, never complained. Knew her role on the team, was okay with it, was a team player, always positive, and like I said, worked her butt off on a daily. I think it says a lot about who she is and has a lot to do with our success to our program. So, Dana, come on up. Next senior is somebody that hasn't been playing ball as long as some of the other girls. Kind of rolled into our facility a while back and started getting some hitting lessons and catching lessons, and just found some passion for the game, some love for the game. Also another kid that's been in our program for a while and first year on Varsity. Again, you know, these players come on, they understand where they are. I think there's a lot of seniors that have the ego, if they're not playing or they're not starting, then they'd rather not play or they'd rather not do it. But these two kids are somebody that came on, they love the game, they love to get to work, they support their team, they knew their role, and never caused any friction with it. You know, so there's something to be said for players like that. They're not easy to find, they're very hard to find. And when she got the opportunity, obviously by that video, you saw what she could do. So, you know, wishing you guys the best at college and everything that you guys are doing moving forward, but I couldn't be more proud of you in the role that you guys have this year. Okay, so Stephanie Cervantes.
The ball at Mesa is still going.
All right, and last but not least, obviously this one I've had for 4 years. I remember walking down to the freshman field and telling Anderson, hey, I want this kid to come up to Varsity. I want to take a look at her. And she came out to the ball field. She ran home to first, and I walked back over there. I said, you're not getting her back. I'm keeping this kid with me. I think 2 days later, she went up to me and said, no, I want to go back. I don't want to be here. I want to go back to my friends. This is not my thing. So I think at the time we were playing soccer and doing other things, but I think, you know, as she started to play more and started to realize how good she was and started to develop more into a softball player, I mean, sky's the limit. You know, this is a player that leads our team. It's the backbone to our team, anchors our field. It just all around, obviously our fire starter, once she goes, we go. But she's gonna be a tough one to replace. I've been doing this a long time. I understand players and what their abilities, and she's just got some intangibles that you cannot teach, you know. So Texas Arlington's definitely getting a good one. We're gonna miss you. Laura Curry. I personally want to thank all three of you guys for being a part of Great Oak Softball for 4 years and, you know, representing what we do here and carrying yourselves, you know, the way the Wolfpack does. And you guys have been, you know, obviously a perfect role model for what the Wolfpack's all about. And I couldn't be more proud of all three of you. Good luck when you're moving on to school and continued success. I know you guys will do great. Thank you. But I didn't. My order's really bad. But, you know, obviously as a coach, you can't do it alone. There's a lot of work. There's a lot of stuff that goes into this. I don't think people realize it sometimes. I'm really bad with this. I have 100,000 things going on a daily. So, you know, keeping up with a lot of the high school stuff is hard for me. So it takes kind of behind the scenes people that handle all this stuff that a lot of people don't even know. But when it comes to anything outside of the dirt, I don't do a lot of it. So, our PSG, Kathy Engler, Amber Preston, and Heather Storms, also Debbie Burrows, special thanks to all you guys because you guys went over and above for anything that we needed, the program needs. You guys are awesome. Like I said, I don't think people sometimes know how much you guys do, and it's easy to sit back sometimes and question what you guys do, but until you're actually the ones doing it, I don't think you'll realize how much it takes, you know, time and you know, from senior day to, you know, checking the softball box to getting checks cut to doing fundraising to organizing banquets. I mean, everything that you guys do is incredible. So from me and our coaching staff, I want to thank you guys very much. You're very important to the program, and we really appreciate it. Also, we're not together, obviously, but I also want to give a thank you to my freshman coaches, Jeff Anderson and Tony Pollock, my JV coaches, Rachel Rife and Rick Hurley, and obviously my coach, Brian Gendro and Janessa Garcia that helped out with this year also. Big thank to you. Tell me something, you'll call the next day to make sure that I still remember what you told me less than 24 hours before. So for me, I just definitely, I couldn't do it without you. And I know the type of person you are, I know how organized you are, and that's why I asked you to do it in the very beginning. I just didn't know you were gonna bring two more like you with you. So it was perfect. Thank you. And last thanks goes to my team, obviously, for you guys just being you and doing what you do. You know, I take a lot of the credit or whatever they say at the end of the day, it's about the coaches, but I think we all know when it comes down to it, you guys are the one putting in the work and doing what you do, playing for the right reason. So thank you.
It says, hey, Lee, recap since I'm not going to be there with you guys. First off, it's been an honor to play with you lovely ladies. We have definitely set the bar high for next year, and I can't wait to see what the future has in store for this program. We have went through so much, and I don't know about you guys, but it felt good to turn some heads this year and prove people wrong. So let me start with the seniors. Since I am not there, this is my goodbye. Dana. Gosh dang, Dana, out of all the seniors, you have grown so much. You came on this team as a quiet, shy individual, but I can tell you that you've grown into such a strong, confident, and a little less of a quiet player. You have put up with so much crap from us, and you have taken all of it. I will never forget our walks to our car at BFE, and I will miss you so much. Do great things out there. Mama, well, that kind of explains it all. I apologize because we've been nothing but trouble for you, but yet you stick around. You have helped us keep our heads out from down south, and I thank you for that. Like Corinne said, thanks for babysitting us this season. I know this year has presented you with nothing but endless challenges, but from those, you have blossomed into such an amazing ball player. I can't wait to see what college has in store for you, Mama. I love you. Thank you. Lo, my outfielder, you have become such a big part of my softball career and have been there for me since my freshman year. I don't know much to say about you without crying, but you have been there for me when I lacked confidence and when I really needed someone to look up to. You have been there by my side and have taught me so much. I don't want you to leave, but I know that the University of Texas Arlington is gaining the most bipolar, loving, passionate, sassy, really sassy beast player. Thank you so much, Laura. Go out there and kill it. Finally, I'm sorry that I couldn't make it tonight. I wish I could be there delivering this to you, but you guys are my family, and I couldn't ask for a better team to play with by my side. But let's stay hungry for next year and frickin' win. See you next year from Q.
Got a little something for you. I just want to say, I have
Autumn was about 9 years old, and I had the pleasure, maybe it was a pleasure, maybe it wasn't a pleasure, coaching with him and getting to know him. And in all the years that I have known you, Ryan, you are by far one of the best people that I know.
Oh,
and
thank you.
I just appreciate everything that you do for this program, and I appreciate that you're here when you don't have a kid on the team. Nicole and Marley and Cody, who's at home, but I appreciate you guys for letting him be able to be here and help the girls. I know you love it as much as he does. Maybe Marley, not so much, but. But thank you. I just wanted to say thank you.
Thank you.
Next year, I think you guys might have a chance to bring home a